Welcome back to my channel. I'm going through the top country artists of all time, compiled in 2017 by Rolling Stone magazine, to better appreciate country music, and to, I guess, shed some of my ignorance. So we're going to hear a song from Tim McGraw, the first of two. This is Live Like You Were Dying from the album of the same name from 2004.
Said I was in my early 40s with a lot of life before me, when a moment came that stopped me on a dime. I spent most of the next days looking at the x-rays, talking about the options and talking about sweet time. I asked him when it sank in that this might really be the real end. How's it hit you when you get that kind of news? Man, what'd you do? And he said, I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Blue Manchu, and I looked deeper, and I spoke sweeter, and I forgiveness I've been denying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. He said, I was finally the husband that most of the time I wasn't. I became a friend a friend would like to have. And all of a sudden going fishing wasn't such an imposition. And I went three times that year, I lost my dad. Well, I finally read the good book, and I took a good long hard look at what I'd do if I could do it all again. I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Blue Manchu, and I looked deeper, and I spoke sweeter, and I gave forgiveness I've been denying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like dying. Like tomorrow was a gift, and you got eternity to think about what you do with it. What did you do with it? What did I do with it? What would I do with it? Skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Blue Manchu, and I loved deeper, and I spoke sweeter, and I watched an eagle as it was flying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying, to live like we're dying, to live like you were dying, to live like you were dying, to live like you were dying.
That was good. I like that. I like the message in that for sure. I mean, yeah, for real. I mean, like, live like you're dying. Because, I mean, nobody knows. Nobody knows what tomorrow holds. You know, tomorrow could be the greatest day of your life. Or tomorrow, maybe someone you care a lot about passes away, right? So, you know, yeah, I think this message is perfect. Yeah, for sure. I mean, live like you're dying. I liked all the, I mean, the references to extreme sports. That was kind of cool. But I think the deeper message is, you know, to embrace life. And I think taking it one step forward, also to, you know, appreciate what you have and the people in your life and let them know how you feel about them. He didn't really touch that much on that, but that's kind of what I thought of when I was thinking about live like you're dying. I mean, if this was your last day, you know, what would you want to do? I think you'd want to let people know what you think about them. What I mean, the people that you love. I mean, people that you haven't got along with. I mean, you shouldn't hold hate in your heart to the grave, I don't think. But yeah, cool song. I was thinking about the lyrics there. Talked about bungee jumping, or sorry, about skydiving. It's one I don't think I could do. I think I could bungee jump because I would see the cord attached, and that is something I think I could do and get a nice adrenaline rush from. Jumping out of a plane, not knowing if it's good, if the chute's gonna come out or not. I don't know, it's a little too much for me, I think. But yeah, cool song. Like I said before, with these newer tracks, because when I did the 2014 list, there was a lot of older songs on there. And it was more acoustic, a lot of reverb. These songs, I can hear that electric guitar, I can hear the high pitchness in there. And, you know, it's just used to emphasize the point of the song. It's not heavy, where obviously it wouldn't be a country song if you did that. But it's cool to hear. I like that. Good song, good message, good all the way around, I think. So we got another one coming up from Tim McGraw. We're going to hear one from his 2015, it looks like a compilation album, of the 35 biggest hits. So let me know what these songs mean to you. When was the first time you heard it, and what does it mean to you personally? And please consider hitting that subscribe button and the notification bell so you know when I upload the next video. Take care, and thanks again.